Welcome to At Home with Gizzelle. I'm Gizzelle. Nuro, a company started by two of Google's top self-driving car engineers, recently received a permit in California to start testing their driverless vehicles for delivery of food and groceries. In true human fashion, there are already videos of people trying to steal those items from the driverless cars. Dell became number one in PC shipments for the first quarter of 2020 with an increase of 10%. In PC-related news, YouTuber Shane Dawson posted a tweet dedicated to Gateway computers over the weekend. The Gateway website saw their first visitors in over a decade. I happen to be one of them. Equinix has offered free virtual backgrounds that are data center themed to make you the life of the virtual party. But last I checked, food or drink wasn't allowed on the data center floor, so it's probably not that cool of a party. Amazon is using thermal cameras to help identify COVID-19 cases based on body temperature. Other things I found that you could do with thermal cameras: make sure that your white wine bottle is the perfect temperature, and also find the coldest can of beer in your refrigerator. Researchers at MIT are starting to recognize that toddlers and preschoolers are developing emotional attachments to robotic devices and artificial intelligence. With that, they're recommending that parents be mindful on how they talk about robotic devices, that they do not assign gender to robots, and that we also frequently remind our children that robots are merely machines created by a mountain of human work. Sorry, Rosie. Technology has become the lifeblood for organizations sustaining themselves throughout this current pandemic. And technology solution providers are having to change their approach in selling into organizations. I've invited Trey Lackey, president of Access Tech, to join me today to talk a little bit about the changes his organization is facing. Trey, it's always such a pleasure to talk with you.
Hey, Gizzelle. It's great to be with you.
Trey, as someone with decades of experience in this industry and that provides such a wide solution set of products, what is the biggest change that you are facing?
Yeah, one of the biggest changes that we're seeing is just 3 months ago, the conversation around mobility for workers had to mostly do with an application on your phone to where you could have your at-office feature set on your mobile device. Now mobility means something completely different, and it's not just a like to have, it's a must have. So businesses are scrambling to get these tools in place to have their workforces be productive. And this is putting a tremendous strain on IT departments. This is also creating a conundrum for the decision makers, as they are not sure what's going to be happening in the next 2 weeks, 2 months, or 2 years. So we're having to really explain to customers what's happening out there to the best that we can, and give them options that provide them scale and flexibility.
What's one bit of advice that you would like to share with others in the agent community?
My advice to the agent community is no different than it would have been 3 months ago. It's us that our clients look to be trusted advisors, to know the difference between the vendors and which ones really are going to solve problems for them. Most importantly, stay safe, reach out to the folks that you care about and love. Don't be shy to lean on folks, be nice to the ones that you live with, because they're very important right now.
Thank you so much for that, Trey. I always enjoy our time together. Next, I'd like to introduce you to Koby Phillips, VP of Cloud for Telarus, one of the largest master agents in the country, and also a brand new Equinix partner. Koby, we just heard from Trey about what he's facing selling directly into some of these customers. You come from a different perspective, being a master agent and enabling these sales organizations to have access to all the different cloud solutions. What changes have you seen recently?
I would say the biggest changes I've seen, I'll kind of answer that a couple different ways. Directly, it's the, you know, all the shift to being completely virtual. A lot of our stuff that we do is in person, and we're, you know, going out and doing events and trainings and meeting with partners. And so to have that completely switched to virtual has certainly been a change. From a bigger picture, like the way it's impacted everybody, I'd say that carries through, but also seeing the suppliers really rush to help support customers and partners to help them enable a work from home strategy, it's really been awesome to see that. Equinix included, of course, and really getting out there and helping people, you know, keep their businesses up and running during this really unprecedented time period.
So I understand that you are new to this role as a VP, which congratulations, by the way. One of the things I wanted to ask you is, as somebody who aspires to be in a leadership role at some point in the future, what has been the hardest thing to acclimate to being in the new role?
I would say the biggest challenge that I've had is really kind of when I attribute it to the same thing whenever I quit playing sports and I started coaching. It was really the shift from being the player to being the coach and trying to make sure that other people are successful and giving them the tools to do so and not being able to directly impact it as much myself. But it's also way more rewarding when you see other people succeed and you're part of that success. For me, that's been really enlightening, and it's been awesome to see that. And so I think that's been the most challenging but also the most rewarding part about it.
And shameless plug, why did Telarus push so hard to become an Equinix partner, and why should everybody be an Equinix customer?
We pushed really hard because of the class act organization that Equinix is. Me working there directly, I got to see it internally, and it only enhanced my point of view there. The culture, the people, everybody's fantastic. The company's go-to-market strategy is top-notch, and that's why we really wanted to align with them as a supplier partner as well. And because of where Equinix sits in the whole technology landscape, right in the middle, connecting customers to their clouds and their networks and everything else, I mean, that also kind of answers that second part of the question, is why would people want to be a customer of Equinix? It's going to give you the best way to connect your end users to their applications in most situations that arise now in our architecture. So we definitely want to make sure that we have access to a supplier that can bring that to the table.
Thank you so much for your time today, Koby. I look forward to watching all the amazing things that you're going to accomplish. That's it for today's At Home with Gizzelle. Until next time.